Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Panda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you ZigBee protocol with complete details. Let me show you outlines of this video first. See, in this video, first I'll explain you basics of ZigBee. Then I'll cover protocol stack of ZigBee. After that, I'll explain you three different topologies used in ZigBee. Then I'll explain you ZigBee devices. There are three categories of device that I'll explain you with great details. At last, I'll explain you advantages and disadvantages of ZigBee. Let us start this video with first agenda, that is basics of ZigBee. See, ZigBee is developed by ZigBee Alliance. And ZigBee is a competitor of 6LoWPAN. One should know, in IoT network, we need to have low power personal area network. So with the use of 6LoWPAN, we are creating it, as well as with the use of ZigBee, we can have low power personal area network, right? So ZigBee is having a competitor, that is 6LoWPAN. Based on 6LoWPAN, I have made video in the lecture series of IoT. You can go through it. In this video, I'll explain you how ZigBee functions, right? See, ZigBee uses IEEE 802.15.4 protocol, and this protocol works at MAC and physical layer. I have made video based on this protocol even. See, ZigBee is using this protocol at data link layer, where media access control comes into the picture, as well as at physical layer, this protocol is there with ZigBee. Even with 6LoWPAN, this protocol functions at data link layer, where MAC comes into the picture, and at physical layer, right? So both of this protocol uses this protocol at data link layer and at physical layer, right? So here in this video, I'll not discuss much about this protocol, as I have made separate video based on this protocol, right? You just go through this protocol in the lecture series of IoT. I have added this video in the lecture series of IoT, right? See, ZigBee is designed for low cost and low power wireless IoT network. So as I have told you, in IoT network, we need to have low cost and low power wireless network, right? And that can be developed with the use of ZigBee. How it can be developed, that even I'll be discussing in great detail in this video itself, right? See, ZigBee is used in low data rate applications that requires long battery life and secured networking. See here, when you form network with the use of ZigBee, at that time, data rate is not the concern. Here our data rate will be less. Highest data rate is 250 kbps with ZigBee network, right? Here our concern is longer battery life, and we need to have low power personal area network with the use of ZigBee, right? How we will be forming that even I'll explain in this video itself. There are three topologies by which ZigBee network can be formed, in which I'll explain you how it can be formed in great detail, right? See, ZigBee is simpler and less expensive compared to Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, right? See, Bluetooth and Wi-Fi, that we use it for higher data rate communication, right? Here in ZigBee, we are having applications with lower data rate, and with ZigBee, we can have lower expenses when you want to form wireless personal area network, right? See, ZigBee is operating with shorter range. You can communicate up to 10 to 20 meter in indoor cases. But as if you want to communicate in outdoor situation, in that case, you will have to form mesh networking where range can be extended up to 500 meter, right? So in indoor, you can have range up to 10 to 20 meter where you don't form mesh network. But if you have outdoor applications, in that case, with the use of mesh networking, one can have range up to 500 meter, right? See, ZigBee operates at 2.4 unlicensed ISM band. This 2.4 gigahertz frequency, that is unlicensed band, which comes under ISM band, industrial, scientific, medical band. To use this frequency, you don't need to take permission of any government. You can use this frequency with any application, right? Many devices are functioning at this frequency. This is unlicensed band, that one can say. See, ZigBee operates at maximum data rate of 250 kbps, right? Now I'll explain you protocol stack of ZigBee. See, in protocol stack of ZigBee, as I have told you, at data link layer and at physical layer, we are having IEEE 802.15.4 protocol, right? For that, I have made separate video. So at physical layer, we have this protocol, as well as at data link layer, media access control comes into the picture. So ZigBee utilizes this protocol at data link layer and at physical layer. For this, I have made a separate video, right? Here we will be discussing about ZigBee for network layer and for application layer. So see, in application and in network layer, ZigBee provides security by encryption of 32 bits, 16, 4 bits, as well as 128 bits, right? But here our major concern is about how networking is done, how routing is done. So for that, you need to understand one thing. See, ZigBee supports different network topologies. Those network topologies can be star. It could be peer to peer, where we will be having mesh topology, or it could be cluster tree. I'll show you these three topologies in great details, right? In ZigBee, we can have three different categories of devices. Highest efficient device, that is ZigBee coordinator. After that, second highest device, that is ZigBee router, which is even referred as full function device. And see, lowest category of device, that is ZigBee end device, which is having reduced function device, that even one can say, right? It is having less functionalities. What are those functionalities and how these topologies can be formed? Let us try to understand that. So here now I'll explain you topologies used in ZigBee. So let me explain you first star topology. See, here central coordinator is there, right? So central coordinator will be what? ZigBee coordinator over here, right? So this is central coordinator, which will be ZigBee coordinator. That is having highest functionalities. It will be having highest memory, right? It can communicate to external network even, right? Here you can observe, here end devices are there. So these end devices are ZigBee end devices, which is having limited functions. These end devices can communicate with central coordinator only, right? Here with this star topology. Now let us talk about second topology, that is peer to peer, or you can say mesh topology, right? Now in this, you can observe, here we are having central coordinator that can communicate to external network. But mesh topology means what? All the devices can communicate with each other. But in this, if you observe carefully, see, this end node is having limited functionality, but here routers are added. Those are ZigBee router, which is having full functions. So these routers can do routing of data, right? Which is having full functions. So here routers are connected. Even if you connect end nodes over here, that is even fine. But just to explain you, see, in mesh topology, sometimes you may need to have large range communication. So for large range communication, we need to add ZigBee routers, which are full function device, right? So here with the use of mesh, we can have full function devices by which we can extend the range even, right? So that is how peer to peer topology is there, where I have added ZigBee routers along with central coordinator, right? See, these ZigBee routers can also function as a central coordinator. If central coordinator is getting failed in that situation, you can use this ZigBee router as a central coordinator even, right? There are a few basic things that you need to understand, that even I'll explain you step by step. Let me explain you third topology, that is cluster tree topology. If you observe here, see, this is what ZigBee coordinator, that is communicating with ZigBee routers, which are full function device. Now ZigBee routers are connected with end devices, right? ZigBee end devices, that is having limited functions, right? So that is how three categories of topologies are there. Now here one thing that you need to note down. See, external network communication that will happen with ZigBee coordinator, right? That is central coordinator. Routers can route the data, right? That is full function device. See, routers and central coordinator, that requires higher power, right? That requires higher power. So routers and central coordinator are not functioning with the use of battery. See, these end nodes are only functioning with the use of battery. Why? The reason is these end nodes just communicates with the interconnected node. It could be central coordinator, it could be router, right? So here you can observe, see, this end node can communicate with this router only, and that communication will be periodic. So these end nodes, which are ZigBee end devices that is having limited functions, they are operated with battery. But this ZigBee router and ZigBee coordinator, that is not operated with battery. It needs supply, right? It needs external supply. So that is how things are there. Now let me explain you this devices, right? So as I have told you, in ZigBee there are three devices. First is ZigBee coordinator. See, in ZigBee network, it has one coordinator node. It can store information. See, this node can control complete network even. The reason is it is communicating with all the nodes, right? It can communicate with ZigBee routers. It can communicate with ZigBee and devices even, right? So it can communicate with external network even. So ZCs and ZRs means ZigBee coordinator and ZigBee routers requires higher power as it can route the data. So it is not operated with battery, right? See, second device is ZigBee router, which is also full function device. In ZigBee network, it can route the data with interconnected node. So here ZigBee routers are playing a role of routing of data, right? It needs lower memory compared to ZigBee coordinators, right? But obviously it is less powerful compared to this. So it needs lower memory, but it can route the data. Remember this. And it can also act as a coordinator as if there is a failure of ZigBee coordinator, right? Now third device, that is ZigBee end device. See, it is least expensive device. Why? The reason is it is having minimum memory. It requires minimum power, so it can operate with batteries, right? And these devices can communicate with only ZR and ZC. See, ZigBee end devices cannot communicate with each other, right? And its communication will be even periodic. It cannot communicate continuously. Periodic communication will be there, right? So as it is having periodic communication, battery utilization will be effective over here. So ZigBee end devices are operated with battery. ZigBee router and ZigBee coordinator are not operated with battery. Remember this. That is how devices and networks are getting formed with the use of ZigBee, right? Now I'll explain you ZigBee advantages. So it is easy to install and implement. See, it has low cost, it is low power device, and it has longer battery life as it is having periodic communication only. End devices are communicating periodic, continuous communication is not happening. So continuous power dissipation is not happening here, right? See, it supports many nodes, around 6500. That many nodes can be interconnected with the use of ZigBee network. So that is quite awesome, isn't it? See, it is more reliable and self-healing. Self-healing means if any node is getting failed, then also entire network will function, right? It is self-healing kind of network, where if some nodes are getting failed, then also entire network will not be disturbed over here. Whatever devices are available with which communication will be continue over here, right? Now I'll explain you disadvantages of ZigBee. See, it has lower data rate. I have told you, for lower data rate only ZigBee is applicable, right? Maximum 250 kbps data rate will be available. It is not secured as Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, right? It is not that secured. See, in Bluetooth we have frequency hopping spread spectrum, and in Wi-Fi we are having so many security protocols. So ZigBee is not secured as Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. One should know this. See, it requires additional devices like ZCs and ZRs, which requires power supply. It adds additional cost over here. So ZigBee network is not getting formed by only ZigBee end devices. We need to have ZigBee routers as well as ZigBee coordinator, that is having bit more cost compared to ZigBee end devices, right? See, it lacks internet protocol support. ZigBee doesn't support internet protocol, right? ZigBee directly cannot communicate with internet. So here you need to have device which can translate the data of ZigBee to internet, right? Which also adds some cost. See, ZigBee network are incompatible with other network. ZigBee network can communicate with ZigBee network only. It cannot communicate with other category of network like Bluetooth, Wi-Fi. Any other network cannot communicate with ZigBee network. That is how disadvantages are there. I hope I have given meaningful insights to you regarding ZigBee in this video. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.